Good morning, students. In last lecture, we have discussed about the classification of matter. Okay, and what is the matter, that also we discussed. So today we will start the main point, that is the classification of matter. In that, what we discussed, the pure substance, then pure substance again it is divided into the element and compound. Okay, and this side I given you the flow chart. Okay, just you see that flow chart. So before to start the elements and compounds, first some basic points that we have to see. So first we will see what is an atom. See, all the things which are present in our surrounding made up of atoms and molecules. You know that whatever the things are present in our surrounding, that all are known as a matter. Okay, what is the definition of matter? Anything has mass and occupies space. Means, for example, this pen is also matter. Okay, this duster is also matter. This board is a matter. Means this, all the things are matter. But how the matter is made up of? See, now we have to go in detail in that. Okay, so any substance, means which substance are present surrounded by us, that all known as matter, and that all made up of from atoms and molecules. Okay, so what exactly atoms and molecules? Now that we are going to discuss here. See, atoms means the very smallest substance. Okay, see here, atoms, and these atom words come from the Greek word that means atomos. Okay, now atomos means what? Indivisible, means anything. See, suppose this pen is also made up of atoms and molecules. Okay, if you will try to break it, okay, part, okay, so the atom is very smallest part of the any substance. So this pen is made up of the atom. See, in the biology you have learned that cell, okay, then tissue, then organ system. The same thing here, what? The atoms, molecules, elements, compounds. Okay, so now first we will see the atom. So what is the proper definition of atom? See, the atom is the smallest indivisible units. Means further you cannot divide the atom. Atom is only the first and last, that is the smallest. Okay, the structure of atom, it is there, means inside the atoms also some subatomic particles are present, but that we are going to discuss in the next when we will start the atomic structure. Okay, so now what you have to know, only the all the things which are present nearby us, that all are made up of atoms. Okay, so what is the proper definition of atom? Atom is the smallest indivisible unit, and all the things around us made up of an atom. For example, chair, book, etc. Now I will show you. See here, you know, sea. Okay, sea means what? See, now this is the one element. Okay, this is the carbon. Okay, so C is a symbol of carbon. Now that symbols of element that we will learn. Okay, so it is a carbon. Otherwise we will take the another, because it is still, it is, we not started the names of elements. Okay, now see here, this is the one dot. Okay, what is this? This is the small unit, smallest unit of any substance. So this is known as a atom. Okay, now see, suppose this is one book. Okay, and we know that book is made up of, book is in a solid state. Okay, so it is also made up of the small unit that is known as a atom. So atom means the smallest part of the substance, and it will not be, it is a indivisible unit. Okay, you cannot break further than the atom. So this is the one dot, means what? It is the smallest unit that is known as a atom. Okay, now the next, see next, what is the atoms, and the next point it is there, that is a molecules. Now molecules means what? where the atoms, one or more atoms combine together, it form a molecule. Okay, now for example, see here, the common that which one you know, oxygen. Now oxygen, everyone you know that. Okay, see, and symbol of oxygen also you know, mostly all the students know about the symbol of oxygen. So see, example here, this is what, O. Okay, so how we are writing O2. Okay, so O2 means what? See, this is one oxygen atom plus second oxygen atom, and it gives O2, means these two atom, this is also atom, and it form a molecule. Okay, see here, this is here, the number is not given, means what? One atom of oxygen, smallest unit, one atom of oxygen, and here also one more atom of oxygen. When these two atoms combine, okay, and it form a molecule. Do you understood molecules means what? Atom means it is a single one atom of the any element, okay. So for example, this is one oxygen atom, and when one or more than oxygen atoms combines, and then form a molecule. So what will be the definition of molecules? When one or more atoms combines together, it form molecules. Okay, write down this definition in your chemistry notebook and write this example also. One more example, see hydrogen. Hydrogen, what is the symbol of hydrogen? H. See here, if I will write here H, so it is of one atom of hydrogen, because see here, number is not given, means what? Only here one number is there. So one atom of hydrogen, this is hydrogen atom. Okay, and suppose if you will write H2, means what? It is a molecule of hydrogen. Why now it is molecule of hydrogen? Because two atoms of hydrogens combine together. See here, this one atom of hydrogen plus one more atom of hydrogen, and it form a H2 molecule. Understood? Means one or more than one atoms combine to form a molecule. So this is the hydrogen molecule, and this is hydrogen atom. Okay, this one is oxygen atom. When one or more atoms combine together, it form a oxygen molecule. Okay, suppose more hydrogen and oxygen, these are the common, and that symbols also you know. So do you understand the molecules and atoms? Just to remember, the atoms vary the smallest unit of, okay, means any substance, smallest unit of any substance, okay. And molecules means what? When one or more than one atoms combines together, it form a molecule of that particular element, okay. So this is the atoms and molecule. So now we will see our main point, that is a element. Okay, now we will see the next, that is element. See, do you know about the atoms and molecules? Atom means what? Very smallest substance, very smallest particle of any substance, okay. And when more than one atoms combine together, it form a molecules, okay. Now we will see our exact point, that is a element. See, an element is a pure substance composed of only one kind of atom. Now see, the pure substance classification, just to see, last lecture I have given you the flowchart. Pure substance classify into elements and compound. So what is a pure substance? See, pure substance means what? It contain only one kind of atom. Okay, means of hydrogen, then only hydrogen's atom. It will not contain more than one element's atoms. Okay, so it contain only one kind of atom. atom, it is a known as an element. An element is a pure substance composed of only one kind of atom, means only single atom is present in that. Single means what? It contains more than one atom. Okay, but not a different element. In one element, suppose now hydrogen is there, okay, and if you are writing the hydrogen H2, so it contains two atom of hydrogen, but it contain only a hydrogen atoms. It will not contain the carbon atom or oxygen atom. Okay, so do you understand elements means what? It contain only one kind of atom. Now for example, coal. See here the picture, it is given the coal. Coal is the purest form of carbon. So it contains, it is the purest substance. Coal, everyone you know. Coal what? Okay, coal is the purest substance. Why? Because it contains only one kind of atom. So coal, the another name, which element it contains, that is the carbon. Okay, so see here picture, it is given this coal is the purest form of substance and it contains only one kind of atom, that is a carbon. Suppose see here, this is the one piece of coal. Okay, this is one piece of coal and see, see, it contain only one kind of atom, means see, more than one atom, but the same element. See, it contain the carbon atom, only carbon atom. Here you can, here oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, nothing else, only the one kind of atom, that is a carbon. So coal is one of the example of the purest form of substance. Okay, so then all the elements, mostly all, you know, maybe if you have the periodic table, there are total 118 elements are there. Okay, so that all the elements, why it is known as the elements? Because they are the purest form of substance and it contain only one kind of atom. So carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, okay, these are the some examples. So these all are the element because it contain only one kind of atom. Okay, do you understand the element means what? Now next period we will learn the properties of elements. Okay, so thank you.